The low-pressure area off the waters of southern Luzon has developed into Tropical Depression Egay. Let's find out how this will affect weather in the country from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Good afternoon, Ariel.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. As you mentioned, the low-pressure area east of the country has developed into a Tropical Depression Egay at 8 this morning. But as I said, it was assigned the international name Doksuri, meaning eagle in Korean. Egay was last spotted 900 kilometers east of southeastern Luzon, attacking winds of 55 kilometers per hour and gusting up to 70 kilometers per hour. It is currently moving north-northwestward slowly. Egay is not yet directly affecting the country's weather and is not seen to hit any part of the archipelago based on PAGASA's initial forecast track. The system will move generally northwestward over the Philippine Sea, where it may intensify continuously in the coming days. Egay may start enhancing the southwest monsoon or habagat beginning Sunday. By Tuesday, it will be east of northern Luzon and reach super typhoon intensity. It will then move closer to Batanes by Wednesday. There will still be changes in the forecast track and intensity of Egay, so please keep monitoring for updates. For today's weather, it's warm over most of the country. However, rains are also expected. Southern Palawan is already experiencing rains from Habagat, while later this afternoon, there will be intense thunderstorms over Pangasinan, Tarlac, Calabarzon, Bicol, Mindoro, the rest of Palawan, most of Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, Northern Mindanao, and Agusan provinces. Rains over Mimaropa and Visayas may persist through the night. This weekend, Habagat will continue to bring rains over Mimaropa, Western Visayas, and Zamboanga Peninsula, and afternoon thunderstorms are forecast over central and southern Luzon and most of Mindanao. And here in Metro Manila, there is a chance of thunderstorm later and tomorrow afternoon. And on Sunday, the skies will be mostly overcast with passing rains. That's the latest on the weather. Happy weekend and back to you, Stan.
Happy weekend to you too, Ariel Rojas. Water concessionaires Maynilad and Manila Water will be relying on their deep well facilities to augment supply amid the El Nino phenomenon. Alvin El Chico with the details.
Some areas in Quezon City, San Juan, and San Mateo Rizal are set to experience a six-hour water interruption from Thursday night to early Friday morning. But Manila Water clarifies this is due to maintenance work.
Kadalasan natatapos naman ito ng siguro mga 3 to 4 hours. Pero binibigyan natin ng panahon para mag-build up yung pressure. Kaya nilalagay na natin ng 6 hours. Sigurado naman na bago o pagdating ng alas 4 ng madaling araw ay okay na.
Maynilad customers meanwhile can rest easy as no water interruption is projected until next week as long as the rains continue over the watershed. The water level in Angat Dam has barely moved in the last 2 days as the MWSS voluntarily reduced its allocation to 39 cubic meters per second due to excess water from Ipo Dam.
The worst case po, no, ay if ever hindi natin ma-receive yung mga ulan this weekend, baka by Wednesday or Thursday, titignan natin ay dun, magpapalik po yung interruption natin. The best case naman po, if ever po napatanggap po natin ang ulan, ituloy-tuloy po na walang interruption for the next 2 weeks po.
The MWSS plans to invite the Dumaga tribe of Angat to do another rain dance soon.
Gumagana. It's worked naman eh. Nakita mo naman, Alvin. Rain dance kami nung Monday. Pagdating ng Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, ay nagulan naman tayo.
Meanwhile, the concessionaires are ready with their deep wells to augment the water supply in the capital. This deep well facility near UP Diliman, developed by Manila Water, can produce 1.2 million liters per day.
Kaya natin binubuksan ng deep wells is to ensure na kapag nagkaroon ng water crisis, is dapat merong unlimited and potable water supply 24/7 para sa mga tao. 400 service connections na po yung nasusupply natin for a 1.2 million liters per day.
Maynilad, on the other hand, has constructed this deep well in Fairview, Quezon City.
This deep well po, around 100 water service connections po yung masusuplayan niya. Since 24 hours pa po yung supply nitong area, so in case po na magkaroon ng interruptions, doon po namin siya pinapagana.
According to the MWSS, Manila Water has 49 operational deep wells, while Maynilad has 7. But the government clarifies these deep wells will not be used continuously.
Kailangan po natin pahingain yung groundwater para ho mag-recharge siya. Kasi po pag continuous po ito na nagbobomba, Siyempre po, yung tubig sa ilalim ng lupa, bababa po yon hanggang sa baka dumating ang punto na wala na mahigop.
According to experts, the government regulates the use of deep wells as it can cause land collapse or sinkholes once the underground water is depleted. Alvin Alchico, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government has partnered with a cybersecurity group to fight the growing number of online scams. More from Jackie Pascual.
Chester Tolentino almost lost his savings when a scammer pretending to be a bank representative offered to convert his credit card rewards to cash. Chester said it appeared credible because the caller knew some of his basic personal details.
Alam niya yung pangalan ko at alam niya na may account ako doon sa banko na yon. So kaya medyo tinuloy ko yung tawag. Maayos din yung script nila at saka medyo mahusay din yung pagkakasalita nila.
He was initially convinced since the fraudster even engaged another scammer to pose as the bank manager.
Hinihingi niya yung username ng online bank account ko. So binigay ko naman kasi mukhang legit naman siya at meron pa siyang kunwaring pinapakausap na manager.
But when he received an OTP or one-time password for a request for password change, he knew he was being scammed. He immediately ended the call and his quick thinking saved him from potentially being a victim. The Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center says Chester's case is not isolated as the number of scams, whether text or online, continues to grow. Scammers would sometimes steal millions of pesos from one victim and whatever amount they can from low-income families. Authorities are advising victims to report the incident and deter scammers from deceiving more Filipinos.
Pag hindi nyo na-report, yung nabiktima sa inyo, mabibiktima ng iba pa. Kawawa naman, tumaas yung online, yung hijacking of online accounts, yung mga SOCMED accounts nyo. Ano-anong rason, hihingan kayo ng pera.
To further raise awareness on these types of scams, the DICT, CICC, and other government agencies have partnered with advocacy group Scam Watch Pilipinas.
Pinakamadami ngayon yung account takeover. Ibig sabihin, yung mga nananakaw ng mga Facebook accounts, saka mga social media accounts. Pag nabiktima ka ng cybercrime, parang nabiktima ka ng COVID, hindi lang ikaw yung maaapektuhan, kundi yung mga taong malalapit sa'yo.
In addition to ramping up awareness campaigns, the CICC have deployed more staff to assist scam victims. The public is also reminded to always report suspicious texts and emails immediately to the government's hotline 1326. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine ICT Department and Telco Company signed a Memorandum of Understanding for the creation of the Connectivity Index Rating. Jackie Pascual joins us again for details. Hi, Jackie.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The Department of Information and Communications Technology has signed a Memorandum of Understanding with telcos and the Private Sector Advisory Council for the establishment of a Standardized Connectivity Index Rating, or CIR. DICT Secretary Ivan John Uy said every established would soon have star ratings similar to a 5-star or 4-star hotels. The rating will be on the connectivity of a particular establishment, such as the speed and even the security of that Wi-Fi connection. Initially, it will cover hotels, restaurants, and other tourist areas. With this initiative, the DICT said this will push telcos to improve their service and for establishments as well and businesses to get a better internet connection. The telcos and DICT will plan what the exact criteria will be for this rating, but Secretary Uy says that they hope to implement it within the year. Among the signatories are representatives from Globe, PLDT Smart, Converge, and Dito. The program is also expected to boost the economy with businesses choosing faster internet connection. And that's the latest, Stanley, back to you.
All right, thanks a lot for the update, Jackie Pascual.